Hello all. Today we are going to discuss the testing techniques under the software testing and quality assurance. So how do we test a system, any particular software system? So for testing, we are providing some input to that. We are observing its process and we are observing its output as well. So this is what the standard procedure to test our system, whether that system is providing the output as per the requirement, as per the format or not. So to test a system, input test data we are giving or providing to the system, and we are observing its output. So we are checking that the behavior of that system in that. So check if the system is behaving as per the expectations or not. Now, if the program does not behave as per the expectations, so we are taking a note on which condition or under which loop that particular thing, particular execution is failed, and later on we are correcting it and again debugging to that system is of the difference between the number of defects found by the test team and the overall defects found for the software. So based on that, these are the points. Now let us consider the type of the or the technique of the testing. So basically there are two types of techniques for the testing comes under which first one is the white box testing and another one is the black box testing. So today we are discussing the white box testing. White box testing techniques analyze the internal structure, the used data structure, internal design, code structure, and the working of the software rather than just functionality as in black box testing. It is also called as the glass box testing or clear box testing, or sometimes it is called as the structural testing as well. So the process of this white box testing is working on the different parameters of your system, such as the input, processing, proper test planning, and its output as well. So input, where it meets to the requirements, functional specification, design documents, and the source. So we are checking or we are testing these are the what are the inputs are coming in terms of the requirement, whatever the customer ka requirement is that. Where we are fulfilling or not, functional specifications, design documentation, and mainly the source code we are testing. The processing, performing the risk analysis for guiding through the entire process. Proper test planning, where designing the test case so as to cover the entire code. Execute the rinse repeat until the error-free software is reached. Also, the results are communicated. And in the output parameter, the preparing the final report for the entire testing process. So the white box testing again having the different techniques under which it is categorized into the two fields. One is the unit testing and another one is the integration testing. Unit testing, again these two types are categorized into the subdivisions like execution, operations, mutation, in integration, top down, bottom up, and hybrid approaches. Whereas the execution testing again categorized into the three parts as the statement coverage, branch coverage, and the path coverage. So these are the types of the white box testing. So the control flow, we can say that the in computer science, the control flow or the flow of the control is the order in which individual statement, instructions or functions are called for the imperative programs are executed and evaluated. The emphasis on explicit control flow distinguishes an imperative programming language from a declarative programming language. Modified condition requires some sort of testing point of view the points. Each entry and exit point is invoked. Each decision takes every possible outcome. Each condition in a decision takes every possible outcome. Each condition in a decision shown to the independently affect to the outcome of the decision. And independence of the condition is shown by the proving that only one condition changes at a time. Code coverage and the branch testing, which measures, which describe the degree of which the source code of the program has been tested. It also creates some test cases to increase the coverage and determining the quantitative measure of the code coverage. In the branching testing, which defines the testing method, which has a main goal to ensure that each one of the possible branches, each one of the possible condition from each decision point is executed at least once, and thereby ensuring that all reachable code is executed. So here is one example is given where we are reading the value of x and value of y, and condition in that addition of the values of the variable x and y, if it is greater than 100, then we are moving to the next condition, that the message as the printing the to the large number, else it is moving to the no and it is ending to that particular branching condition is. Based on that, the testing in the white box is going to be executed in such a way. So there are the numbers, are the number of different steps are given over here. But we can consider that steps in terms of the ABCD format as well. Cyclomatic testing in software testing is used for measuring the complexity of the software program. It is a quantitative measure of the independent parts in the source code of the software program. Cyclomatic complexity can be calculated by using control flow graphs or with respect to functions, modules, methods, or classes within a software program. So this is the example for the cyclomatic complexity, how we can make the calculation. As the branching statements are comes into the picture, this complexity may get changed. Advantages of white box testing is, we can say that it is very thorough as the entire code and the structures are tested. It results in the optimization of a code, removing error, and helps in removing extra lines of code. It can start at an earlier stage as it doesn't require any interface, as in case of black box testing, and it is easy to automate as well. Thank you so much.